Marcus Matthiasen says, my calcium intake is low, around 400 milligrams a day, because I don't tolerate many calcium-rich foods. My blood calcium is normal. PTH is mid-range. Vitamin D is 48 nanograms per milliliter. Hair calcium is high. RBC calcium is in the third quintile. Do you think my calcium status is sufficient, or should I take a supplement? I think the overwhelmingly important marker here is the PTH. You said the PTH is in the middle of the normal range, which means to me that it's at the high end of the optimal range, or maybe a little bit outside it. So the normal, I believe that PTH outside the context of clinical issues with tumors and you know, medical problems in the parathyroid gland that are not relevant to nutrition, most of the time, what PTH is signaling is the body's own perception that the calcium vitamin D economy is deficient. And the vitamin D requirement, or the marker, the optimal ranges for 25-OHD, which is the marker of vitamin D adequacy that's used, are set on the basis of population level maximal suppression of PTH. So I look at it this, as if you want to individualize the vitamin D calcium requirement, you look at individual suppression of PTH in a person. I don't know for sure where the cutoff is. I suspect, based on the data that I've seen, which I don't think are adequate, but there's enough data out there from randomized controlled trials to get a general sense of what the point, the average point of maximal suppression is. And that seems to be around 30. I've seen some data that make me think maybe it's around 20. And I also have reasons to speculate that maybe it's different in every person, and maybe that the point of maximal suppression is a range between 20 and 30. So what I would do is, I would first, my suspicion is that your intake is probably fine for you, but I would, and I'm assuming that by mid-range, you mean it's 30. If you mean it's 40, then no, you're deficient, or you're probably deficient, and you need to test whether, how you respond. But what I would say is, it would still be good for you to try increasing that and see if the PTH goes down anymore. Because my baseline for where I suspect someone's PTH is maximally suppressed is 30. But the evidence that it's maximally suppressed is that it doesn't get suppressed by more calcium and vitamin D. If it goes down in response to calcium and vitamin D, then it wasn't maximally suppressed. And you, where you want to be is not 30 or 20. It's the point of maximal suppression. Then the final thing is, magnesium deficiency can compromise your ability to make PTH. And I don't think that the average person in our society is deficient enough in magnesium for that to be relevant, on the basis that population-wide, most people have too much PTH, and that contributes to osteopenia and osteoporosis. But the big caveat here is, if you are magnesium deficient, then that might invalidate most of what I said if you're deficient enough to affect PTH. So, you know, most probably, if you mean 30 or below. Okay, Marcus, if you're posting up a follow-up question, then you, actually everyone, if you're posting up a follow-up to your current question that is relevant, make sure you do it as a reply. If it's a new question, then do it as a new question. Anyway, Marcus, my suspicion is, if your PTH is around 30 and not higher than that, you're probably fine. But it's good to know your magnesium status, because if it's really bad, that could change that interpretation. And it's also good to know if adding more calcium suppresses your PTH further, because if it does, that's probably calcium that you need.